Okay, here we are. I'm in my Spider-Man outfit today. I'm on the mountain bike, doing a bit of a training session. So instead of doing the normal thing, I am doing a grinding training session today. So practicing in and out the saddle, just repeats of a little hill at the back of my place. Altogether, I did 15 repeats, I think, of this. And my average cadence was 55 or 56 cadence. At some points I was going up at 46, you see it about 40, 45 cadence there. So well and truly in the lower end of that cadence range, and that is going to make you stronger. It will make your legs stronger, for definite. This is doing it at a lower cadence like this is similar to building your biceps up in bodybuilding. You know, you've got to do less reps, heavier weights, and this is basically what I'm doing, except for my legs. I'm doing less reps, let's say, at that lower cadence, and that is making my legs fatigue. It's making them fatigue. It's hurting them. You know, it's ripping that muscle. And then obviously you give it time to repair, and as it repairs, it gets bigger and stronger. And this is a great way to get stronger on the bike all round, not just for hill climbing. For me, this sort of training has enabled me to get stronger in all aspects of my cycling, from climbing to sprinting to running along the flats. You know, it's not all about doing the same boring, mundane thing on your training each time. You gotta mix it up. Mix it up a bit and make it hurt. That's how you're gonna get stronger. As I said earlier, I also like to practice the in and out the saddle. Now, if you can get to the point where you're comfortable on a hill climb out the saddle, it's going to give you an advantage over the guy next to you. Definitely in the saddle is the most efficient way and the easiest way, they say, to climb a hill, and it is. Okay, that's the way that you use the least energy. But when you're doing a real long climb, it doesn't hurt to be able to get out of the saddle, let that blood get back down to the legs quicker, so you're not cutting that supply off too much, especially if you're on a 10-15k climb or whatever. It's good to be able to have the ability to get out the saddle, use your different leg muscles, and let that blood recirculate and let it all start flowing and that nice and properly again, without the restriction of sitting on the saddle. It just gives you a bit of a rest, even if you only do it for 100 meters or so. It just gives you a rest. It gives your legs that blood to get back down there, and then you can start plowing away again when you sit back in the saddle. So it's definitely an advantage to you to practice that. And that's why with my training sessions, I practice everything. I practice my spinning a lot. I practice spinning on the flats, but I also practice grinding. And that is how you get stronger. You have to mix it up. Make your training worthwhile, you know? Training is not about breaking KOMs. It's not about smashing the fastest time up a hill. Training is about getting stronger. So there you go, another great way you can do a training session, grinding. You can do this out on the bike, you can do it on your mountain bike, your road bike, or you can also do it on your indoor trainer. It's just another way to mix up your training a bit and make you stronger on the bike.